Hello and welcome to my channel. In this tutorial, I would like to share how I created this simple kinetic text animation. Let's see the preview. Before getting into this topic, I would like to thank you for being here and supporting me. If you are new to this channel, consider subscribing, that would be highly appreciated. Don't skip the video, please watch the video completely. Let's not waste any more of the time, let's get started. Open up After Effects and create a new composition. I am choosing a 1920x1080 composition, the frame rate of 30 and a duration of 5 seconds. Name the composition as main. Create a new solid layer. I am choosing a light grey color solid. Search for gradient ramp from the effects and presets panel and apply it into the solid layer. Click on swap colors and change the colors as you like. Search for noise from the effects and presets panel and apply it into the solid layer. Set the amount of noise to 3%. Create a new text layer and type in your text. I am typing in title design. Align the text to the center of the composition. Create a shape layer. So click on the pen tool and set the fill to none and stroke to solid color. Set the stroke width to 10. We are about to create a line. A slanting line between the two words as shown. Create another shape layer. Now set the fill to solid color and set the stroke to none. Create a shape layer as shown. Rename the shape layer to matte. Bring down the matte layer above the text layer. Rename the shape layer 1 to line. Change the track matte of the text layer to alpha. Duplicate the text layer. Create another shape layer with fill as solid color and stroke as none. For the convenience, I am turning on the visibility of the matte layer. And create a shape as shown. That's good. Rename the shape layer 1 to matte 2. Drag down the matte 2 layer above the second text layer. Change the track matte of the text layer 2 to alpha matte 2. Now turn off the visibility of the matte layer. Press P to bring up the position property of the first text layer. At 1 second 10 frame mark, create a keyframe for position. And at the start of the timeline, change the position as shown. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Go to the second text layer, press P to bring up the position property and at 1 second 10 frame mark, create a keyframe and at the beginning of the composition, set the position value as shown. Select the two keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open up the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Now RAM preview this. I'm not satisfied with the color of the background. Select the line layer. Press S to bring up the scale property. At 10 second mark, create a keyframe. And at the start of the timeline, unlink the x and y values and change the y value to 0. Select the two keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Now RAM preview this. The animation could be much more longer, so I am dragging back the second keyframe to somewhere around 20 seconds. That's better. I am also dragging back the keyframes of the position property of the text layers to somewhere around 2 seconds. Now RAM preview this. That's looking much better. Search for transform effect from the effects and presets panel and apply it into the text layers. At 1 second 20 frame mark, create a keyframe for position for the two text layers. At 2 second 10 frame mark, set the Y value of the position to 480 for the second text layer. Click on the first text layer and change the Y value to 600. Now RAM preview this. It's looking better. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Search for ramp, gradient ramp effect from the effects and presets panel and apply it into the first text layer. Click on the swap colors and change the color as you like. Search for drop shadow effect from the effects and presets panel and apply it into the first text layer. Change the distance to 25 and softness to 10. Search for bevel alpha effect from the effects and presets panel and apply it into the first text layer. Select the gradient ramp effect, drop shadow effect and the bevel alpha effect and copy them. Select the second text layer and paste the effects. Also paste the effects to the line shape layer. I am not satisfied with the background color, so I am changing the background color. Search for glow effect from the effects and presets panel and apply it into the second text layer. Set the glow intensity to 2. Copy the glow effect and paste it into the second text layer. As well, paste it into the line shape layer. Now RAM preview this. It's looking good, but not the colors. The colors I chose are not good. Drag the first position keyframe backwards for about 10 seconds. Do this for the another text layer also. Now RAM preview this. Yeah, that's good. Still, I am not satisfied with the background color, so I am changing the background color. Now that's better. I am also changing the color of the text layers. I am doing this for the another text layer also. Also, I am changing the color of the line shape layer. Select all the layers and right click and click on pre-compose. Name the composition as text and click on move all attributes and click OK. Go to composition and click on composition settings and change the duration to around 10 seconds. Now duplicate the text composition layer. Reverse the duplicated text layer. Right click and click on time. And click on time stretch, and in the stretch factor set the value to -100 and click on OK. Drag the duplicated text composition as shown. Trim the positions as shown. Now RAM preview this. That's good. That's it. Let's see the output once again. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you do so, click on the like button and share it with your friends. The music used in this video is from No Copyright Sounds. The track is called Time, made by Syncol. I will leave a link in the description. If you want the track, you can choose that. Consider subscribing my channel. Hit on the bell icon for notifications. Please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Also, if you have anything to ask, feel free to comment down below. Once again, thanks for being here. This is Raudran signing off.